Foils. They're shiny, colorful, and many have special effects that are pretty darn dazzling. While I don't use them every day, I do reach for them pretty often. And now that I've figured out I can pair them with dyes in our sticky stuff, I know I'll be bringing them into my work more regularly. In today's video, I'll explore a couple of options for foiling die cuts. I'm using iCraft Deco Foil as well as Gina K Fancy Foils, and both are on sale, reduced by 25% effective today. Links to the products can be found in the expanded description below. I am a latecomer to the world of working with dyes, but the more I have a chance to play with them, the more I realize how useful they are, and there are so many different ways that you can work with them. Ideas seem to pop into my head all of the time, and working with dyes or die cuts and foils was a recent one, and the more I played, the more I realized how cool the effect was. I mean, foil is shiny. You all know that I love shiny stuff, so in my world, pairing foils and die cuts is just a very good thing. Before I forget, we're going to work with a new hashtag on Instagram. It's going to be Create with Joggles, and I hope that you'll use it on your projects when you create with the stuff that you bought from us. We want to see it, and we want to be able to share it. Okay, so moving back to the dies. I've got two sets here that I'm working with today. I've got a group from Creative Expressions and Sam Poole, and some of Tim's. So looking at Sam's first, we have, this is named Shabby Basics Shabby Doily. This is Shabby Basic Rustic Honeycomb. You've seen me use this before. You've seen me use this cheesecloth before. And I've certainly used the dappled ovals. All right, so that is the Sam Creative Expressions one. From Tim, we have this marvelous one that's named Crochet. This is named Adorned. It's got all these fun filigrees, these kind of curly cues. Oops, there's one falling out of the envelope. This one is named Celebration Words, and it's script. And then finally, we have this one that is named Wildflower Stems Number 1. All right, so with the dies themselves covered, let's take a look at some of the foils. So from iCraft Deco Foil, you have a bunch of different options. You have solid colors like this black and this magenta that are shiny. You have the occasional color that is available in satin. And then you have these really cool holographic ones, and I'm going to show you a couple examples made with them. And then even better, you have really cool colorways that change like this. So these are named, what's this one? This is Mystic Rainbow. And this one is named Summer Rainbow. So I'm going to work with a sheet of this in a few minutes. And this one is named Rainbow Shattered Glass. So you can see in here all that patterning along with the color change. They are so cool. And like I said, I'm going to show you some examples. In addition to the deco foil, I have some foils from Gina K. They're named Fancy Foils. Now, I've got the specialty ones here, but there are solid colors in this line too. These are out of the package. I don't remember what the names of them are, but they're going to be pretty obvious when you come to the website and you see them. So we have things like this glittering green, sparkling silver, and then this one is really cool. How awesome is that holographic? It looks like sequins. So we have dies and we have foils. Let's talk about the ways to foil cut dies. There are a couple of options. The first one is simple. You die cut some of our sticky stuff, you put it down, and you foil it. The second option requires a couple of more steps. Now, I will admit that when you do this, and I'm going to show you how, it's fiddly because there's really not a lot of body to this once you start to take the backing paper off. So as I peel this, you can see that I've halved the thickness of this. It can be a little bit fiddly. To work around that, what is less fiddly, you can see the sticky stuff here, it's got the shine on it. This is just a piece of white cardstock. If you mount the sticky stuff to the cardstock first, now you've used the adhesive on one side, and then you die cut the piece that you've, excuse me, if you die cut here where you've got sticky stuff on the cardstock, now when you peel this off on the top, you'll have adhesive on the top, but you've got cardstock on the back. So the difference between this and this is less fiddly, but you've got a couple of more steps because you got to put the sticky stuff on the cardstock and then you have to adhere it in place afterwards. And I'm actually going to show you both of these things, but I'm going to show you a couple of samples too. So these were all done using the just die cut the sticky stuff option. So this is Crochet, and I don't know if you can see it in here. I don't remember if this is one of the holographic deco foils or if this is just turquoise. This is one that is holographic. You can see kind of how that color changes. It's really cool. This is that shabby doily. This is the honeycomb. You can see a little less of that kind of holographic effect because there's less of the actual foil. And this is one of those super groovy ones where the color changes. I think these are just so eye-catching. This one, I think, was done with the Gina K with that sparkling pink one, but the pieces are small, so it's a little hard to see a lot of details. You just get that all-over sparkly effect. And then, let's move those out of the way. You have this. Now, this is one that was done on cardstock, and this is done where it was just sticky stuff. And visually, there is really no difference. If you look at this kind of in as a cross-section, and it's very hard to do on camera, this is a little bit thicker simply because it's got cardstock on it. But if you find that working without the cardstock is fiddly, then just do it that way and you take the extra steps to glue the cardstock in place. Okay, so before I forget, where this can be superior is when you're working with something like this, where you've got little tiny pieces that are pretty flimsy. If you put this on the cardstock first, I can pretty much guarantee you're going to find it a little bit easier. I mean, I've done it both ways, and because I'm lazy, I want to skip the extra gluing step, so I skip the cardstock and I just work with it the way that it is. All right, so now let's take a look at this process. So this is just one of our oval pages. This is on craft, and this is one of the, whatever I said that was named, adorned or something like that. This is one of those filigrees. So this is just a piece of sticky stuff that I die cut. This is the backing paper. I just took it off, so now it's sticky on one side, and I'm going to lay this here like this. Now you need to get this adhered on there really well, and I find the best way to do that is to brayer the heck out of it. That way I know that it's on there, and when I start to take this backing paper off, I'm not going to find that the sticky stuff is coming off of that page because it hasn't adhered real well. So this is just turquoise. I'm going to use that on here. Now what I have to do is get the release paper off. So as I peel this back, if I hold this, you can see the sticky stuff on there. So now all I'm going to do is lay the foil on there, and you can either do this with your hands, you can brayer it. Sometimes I do both. If it's a big design, I'll probably brayer it, but this is not enormous, and so it's not going to take that long to actually get it on there. And then it's just a matter of peeling that back. And how awesome is that? You've got all that shine, you've got that pretty turquoise color, and it just works. So there's nothing that says that you have to use this hole. If you want to cut a piece of it, you can. So I'm going to trim. This is crochet. It's one of the four, I think, designs that's in there. Again, this is just sticky stuff. And if I want to go ahead, I can put this on the bottom here. And I, even though it won't entirely fill the bottom, because of the way the repeat works, one of those bumps pretty much does it. There was a little piece in there. You want to be certain that all the little pieces have fallen out. So what I'm going to do is fiddle with this for 1 second. There we go. I need to get that release paper off. There's the sticky side. So how would it look if I, you know what? I think I'm going to do it this way. That looks kind of cool. So I'm just going to go ahead and line this up and brayer it on there so I know I've got good adhesion. And then go ahead and remove the backing paper. I know it's there. There we go. On some of these really big pieces, the backing paper might tear as you take it off. It's no big deal. You just keep at it until it's all gone. All right, what have I got here? Let's find something fun. I'm looking for something else. Well, I'm not finding it. So we're just going to grab, this is that Stars. This is one of the Gina K specialty colors. It's not perfect with this background, but I won't tell anybody if you don't. Again, I'm just going to go ahead, and so when you foil, you're always going to put the color, the finished side, is up toward you. The silver side is on the back. That's the part that touches the adhesive. And then just go ahead and pop that off. And again, so, so pretty. All right, so now let's bring in one of the specialty foils. This is the one named, I don't remember, that I said I was going to use. It's the one named Mystic Rainbow. So this is what the sheet looks like when you take it out. And you'll find this is repeated over many of them. So for example, and I don't remember the names of these, but although this is the shattered rainbow, or the rainbow shattered, whatever it's called, you can kind of see that. This is another one where, again, you've got color changes on it. And these are the ones that are so impressive when you foil. So this is a 5x7 craft index card. Again, this is just done on sticky stuff. So what I need to do is peel this back. All right, so there's the release paper. There's the sticky side. And I'm just going to put this kind of like this. I have no idea what I'm going to do with this after the fact, but it doesn't matter. I'll go ahead and brayer this on. And then I will remove the backing paper on this side. You can see that the backing paper tears. Again, it really doesn't make a darn bit of difference if you take it off in one piece or three. So I'll just go ahead and grab the rest of this and get this off. And then, all right, so I need to just trim that because that's overhanging a little bit. All right, well, we're just going to ignore that. And then we will go ahead and peel this off. If I could get that piece of paper up. And I don't mind spending a couple of minutes to do this because the effect is so worth it. All right, again, you can see the sticky stuff on there. There's a piece overhanging. I'm just going to kind of bend it to the side. So now the question becomes, do I want my stripes to run horizontally or do I want them to run vertically? And in this case, because I think I'm going to orient this in the portrait style, I think I want them to run vertically. And then I can choose, well, let's move that. I can choose, because this is only about 4 inches wide and this is 6 inches, I can choose which part of this stripe area I want to use. I mean, it's a repeat, so I'm just going to lay that on there randomly, sort of in the middle. And because this is a bigger area, I am going to use the brayer first. And then, as I said, I do like to come in with my fingers and just push to make sure I've got really good adhesion. All right, and I can pop this off. Now, I can see right here that I don't have all of the foil transferring properly, and sometimes that happens. I try not to sweat the small stuff. There's a lot of other things in my world that I can get aggravated about. I'm not going to spend too much time worrying about this. And how awesome is that? You've got the shine, you've got the color change. I mean, I just love working with foils. And now that I know I can do it with dyes, it means that the whole world has opened up again. I've got more things that I can even do it with. So I'm going to come back in a minute and I'm going to talk to you some more about this method. Oops, if I can grab it, where we use sticky stuff adhered to cardstock, which again gives you a piece that's a little bit less fiddly to work with. Moving on to the sticky stuff and cardstock technique. As I mentioned in the last segment, this is an 8.5 by 11 piece of cardstock. I trimmed the 6 by 12 piece of sticky stuff so it covered the length, and that piece that's left over I'll do whatever with. We have sticky stuff in both sizes. We have it in 6 by 6 and 6 by 12. So here is one of the flowers that I cut from that piece. This is cardstock on the back. And this is the release paper on the sticky stuff. There is no adhesive here because it was used to attach the sticky stuff to the cardstock, which means I need to get adhesive on the back. And to do that, super easy, and it's very good with small pieces or pieces with lots of openings, like the dappled ovals or the cheesecloth or any of those that I showed you in the last segment. This is Graphics Artist Tack, and it is little tiny dots of adhesive. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to show this to you, but if I take the release paper off one of these sides, if I could get it to lift up here, there we go. All right, so if I hold this up to reflect in the light, can you see those little tiny spots of adhesive? What this is really good for is especially things like this. I don't want to use sticky stuff because if I use that, I'm going to end up with adhesive showing through the openings. This, the adhesive only sticks to where there's cardstock. So you put it, put the side down on the adhesive that you want the adhesive to transfer to, and then you rub this with your finger, or your thumb in my case, and what happens is you get artist tack that transfers from the carrier sheet to the back of your piece. So this is now attached, more or less, and if I go to peel this off, you can see the artist tack is adhering to the back of what is the cardstock. And I can feel it. I don't know, you probably wouldn't be able to see the dots. So all I'm going to do is put this on here. And the nice thing about these little narrow stems is that you can kind of change the curve if you want on them. All right, again, I'm going to come in and brayer this on. Now, artist tack is repositionable for a short period of time, and then ultimately it becomes permanent. So I'm going to go ahead and trim this off. All right, let's get rid of that. And foil. I've got, this is the shattered rainbow. I'm going to have a really colorful flower when I get through. So I'm just going to go ahead, and again, I've got to get this release paper off of here. And you just kind of have to gently ease it off. All right, so now, sticky, ready to be foiled. I think I'm going to go vertical on this too, and I want a little bit of the turquoise because I've got turquoise on there, and I've got a little bit of pink. This is not an enormous flower, but we will see what we can do here. So again, I'm going to go ahead and press this with the brayer, and then I'm going to get in there with my thumb and get that foil adhered. Now, there is a little design on the top of these. There's little dots, and so that foil might not transfer perfectly. But again, I got bigger things to lose sleep over. I'm not too worried about it. So I didn't get as much pink as I probably thought that I would, but you can see how that changes color, and you can see that kind of shattered look that's on there. So the only difference between what I just did and what I did in the last segment is that you have the extra step. You have to adhere extra steps. You have to adhere the sticky stuff to the cardstock, and then once you die cut the piece, you have to put some adhesive on the back so that it will actually stick. But that's it. This is how marvelously simple working with foils and, if I could find my samples, working with foils and die cuts is. I mean, there's just so many different ways that you can do this, whether you're creating a background that you want, or a layer that you want to really stand up and have some punch, or you want a layer that is a little bit less in your face, or you want, again, something like this that becomes part of whatever the focal point of that particular index card ends up being. So don't forget to use the Create with Joggles hashtag so that we can see what you're doing, and I hope you have as much fun working with dies and foils as I did.